Hi everyone, my name is Siti Nabila and known as Cikgu Bella or Teacher Bella. I'm a Southern Tigress because I come from a southern of Malaysia, which is popular as Southern Tiger State, Johor. Previously, I'm teaching multimedia visual for special needs students from various categories such as autism, syndrome down, slow learner, hearing impairment, and many more. That is why inclusivity is my forte. But now I'm moving one more step towards I am in charge for professional development specialist in teacher training for special needs children. So I must learn more about this area of knowledge. Because of that, I am glad to present about this interesting topic with all of educators in the world. So enjoy it. So today, I will share about accessibility tools to support diverse learners with all of you. I will be explaining about few tools that are very useful for educators and students. All of these tools can be found in Microsoft 365. So, I hope that everyone can use all those tools and make your lesson more meaningful and easier after this session. So guys, here I want to introduce to you five types of accessibility tools to support diverse learners, which is a teacher can support academic improvement for all students with tools that enable inclusive teaching. At the same time, students also can use those tools to help them in self-learning process. First tools is built-in subtitles, so they can get real-time subtitles and translation of text, websites, and voice. The second one is accessibility checker, which is it can always run in the background and ensure your Word, PowerPoint, Excel documents are accessible. The third one is Office Lens, which is digitize your whiteboard or blackboard notes and convert them to Microsoft Word, PowerPoint or PDF, which is make it easier for them. And the fourth one is Microsoft Stream, which is you can get an automatic transcription of audio or video recordings. And last but not least is of ease of access settings, which is it can make PCs more accessible and make accessibility easier to discover, learn and use. Learning Tool was a project in the 2015 hackathon and is now helping millions of people worldwide to read and write. So as you see, this is my students that my special needs student, which is not all of them can read or can write even. But after few sessions with immersive reader, I'm using an immersive reader, they can read and they build their confidence to read because they can hear the correct way to pronounce. So it's a very, very, very useful tools that I love it so much. We go to the next one, live caption and subtitles in PowerPoint. As you speak, built-in subtitles will display live directly on your PowerPoint presentation in any one of more than 10 supported speech languages and subtitle into any one of the 60 plus supported written languages. This feature can also be used for audience who are deaf or hard of hearing. Like I've said before, I'm teaching hearing impairment students, so they are using this one. It's a very useful tool for them. As additional info, live subtitling can speak in any of 10 supported languages such as Arabic, Chinese Mandarin, English, French, German, Italian, Japanese, Portuguese, Russian, and Spanish. And subtitle into any one of the 60s plus text translation language. It's such a wonderful tools because everyone in the world can use. And then the other one is customized speech recognition. So optionally, customize the speech recognition engine using the vocabulary within your slides and slide notes to adapt the jargon, technical terms, product or places name, and etc. Personal translation. Using this one, you can share a quick response code or QR code or 5-letter conversion code, and your audience can follow along with your presentation on their own device in their own chosen language. It's great, right? Okay, multi-language Q&A. When you unmute the audience to allow question from the audience on their device in any of the supported language, I mean 10 spoken questions and 60 plus for written ones. Okay, and inclusivity through accessibility. This one, I love it so much, which is it help audience members who are deaf or hard of hearing follow the presentation and participate in the discussion, so they are not left behind. Translate your presentation while preserving the slide formatting. Okay, next to the start subtitles icon, the translate starts button allows presenters to translate their whole presentation while preserving in formatting. And then use case. This is great for people who don't speak the same language as the presenter or need additional help following along. It can also change commonly used jargon to make it easier for people to understand. Ease of access setting. Okay, using this setting, it allows you to make your PC more accessible in just a few quick steps. So you can use your PC without a display. Narrator lets you hear audio descriptions or four elements on the screen like text and buttons. And then you can see what is on the screen. Make the content on your screen bigger using magnifier or use high contrast mode, which is very useful for visual impairment students. Okay, and use your keyboard. You can turn on sticky keys, toggle keys, filter keys, and on-screen keyboards. And also use your mouse. When you use your mouse, change the pointer size or turn on mouse keys to use your keypad to move the mouse. So it's very good for diverse learners, which is they are not will be left behind because they can access all the documents, all those things very easy. We go to the next one, accessibility checker. Can now always run in the background and easily discoverable in Word, Excel, PowerPoint, OneNote, Outlook, and Visio. The accessibility checkers analyze your materials and provides recommendation alongside your document, helping you understand how to fix errors and create more accessible content over time with automatic alternate text in the checker, PowerPoint, and Microsoft Word. Use AI to automatically provide image description. Okay, now the accessibility checker identifies an expanded range of issues within a document, includes a recommended action button, action menu, and utilize AI to make intelligent suggestion for improvement. So you can select chest accessibility under the review tab to get started. So in 2019, accessibility checker has been updated for color contrast detection, remove detection of heading, more efficient fixes, add an object as decorative, simplified alternate text, reading order in PowerPoint, and additional templates. Okay, video and audio transcription, automated transcripts. While viewing a video or listening to an audio file, a full transcript will show directly in the viewer. This example GIF is in stream and support over 320 different file types. It's very nice, right? Last but not least, learning tools and editor. Microsoft Learning Tools empowers students to improve their reading skills by reducing visual clutter, assisting in pronunciation and highlighting individual words. We believe that design with and for people with disabilities will lead to greater innovation for everyone. So today, Immersive Reader is available in over 30 languages and used by over 13 million monthly active users. And more importantly, it has increased reading speed and comprehension for students of all abilities, leading to test scores that were 10% higher than students who did not use Immersive Reader. Immersive Reader can be found in OneNote, Word, Outlook, Office Lens for iPhone and iPad, Microsoft Edge browser. If you want to use the features in learning tools that can help you to focus on the content on your screen, you can use Enhanced Dictation, which is improved authoring text, Focus Mode, to sustain attention and improves learning speed. Immersive reading improves comprehension and sustain attention. Font spacing and short lines improve reading speed by addressing visual crowding. Parts of speech support writing instruction and improve writing quality. Syllabification improves word recognition. Comprehension mode improves comprehension by the average of 10%. Use case, these tools are great to use in the classroom if there's a student who's struggling to read or if a person has a disability such as dyslexia and dysgraphia. So, everyone, now I want to let you see how my students improve after using all those accessibility tools for their lessons. Self-learning process. Present in front of others. Coaching friends in the classroom. And the best part, entering an international competition in Korea. So educators, if you are already an MIE, log into your education.microsoft.com and click your profile circle in the upper right corner and select redeem achievement code and enter the code given here, TSBA2C7B21, T-SBA2C7B21. Then find the session on your transcript by clicking My Profile and then clicking on View Transcript in the upper right corner. It will say Custom Training. If you aren't an MIE yet, once you've joined us for 2 hours of content and redeemed the associated codes, you will earn your Microsoft Innovative Educator badge. So don't miss it. So thank you everybody. Thank you Microsoft. Thank you Sonja. Thank you Erin. And thank you Microsoft Malaysia.